Why are you facing it that way?
You're facing this way.
Okay, so Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Rhodes Stadium in tonight's game between the Cinco Ranch Cougars and the Morton Ranch Mavericks. If you could please draw your attention to midfield, we'd like to introduce our Good Sportsmanship League. The Good Sportsmanship League is a long-time existing tradition of Texas high school sports. Both groups represent class and good sportsmanship from their schools. From Morton Ranch, the GSL members are Kendra Oribe, Taylor Armstead, Brianna Henry, Tara Ramos, Tyra Patterson, and Kristen Mueller. The GSL sponsor from Morton Ranch is Charlene Marsh. The representatives from the Cinco Ranch High School Good Sportsmanship League are Abby Drott, Megan Esch, Haley Henry, Jordan Torres, Shay Van Cleve, Christy Vogelsang, Claire Bieber, Lauren Brown, Julia Chesnick, Kendall Crow, Madison Cummings, Sydney Hodgick, Sasha Hernandez, Catherine Martinez, Victoria Moore, Katie Rinderneck, Jamie Schur, and McKaylee Strong. The GSL sponsor is Mrs. Beverly Shepherd. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give a big round of applause for our Good Sportsmanship League and the representatives. And now, introducing your Morton Ranch High School varsity cheerleaders. Introducing Brittany Anderson. Alana Bell. Demetria Frank. Brianna Hernandez. Brianna Henry. Ileani Hurtado. Kimberly Ochoa. Tara Ramos. Diana Sandoval. Chloe Sledge. Mia Villalobos and Anaya Williams. And the Maverick mascot is DJ Ray. The manager is Jordan Russo, and your flag runners are Jason Everly, Justin Johnson, Robbie Brown, Jeremiah Green, and Simon Luth. Ladies and gentlemen, your Morton Ranch High School cheerleaders. And now, introducing your Cinco Ranch High School varsity cheerleaders. The Cinco cheerleaders were UCA camp champions. Introducing senior Paige Clark. Senior veteran, All-American, and co-captain Reagan Downman. Junior Rachel Henderson. Senior veteran and your varsity captain, Anna Kalergis. Junior Carly Knott. Junior Mandy Lee. Senior veteran Melissa McDonald. Junior Brooke Nicholson. Junior Emma Pitcock. Junior Ava Rinderneck. Junior Sydney Rendernick. Junior Sarah Shepherd. Senior veteran All-American and co-captain Samantha Torres. Senior veteran All-American Shay Van Clee. Junior Lauren Villarreal. Senior Shannon Woolsey. And the mascot is sophomore Grayson Sidner as Coco the Cougar. The coach is Angie Eller. And the cheerleader of the week is Lauren Villarreal. Ladies and gentlemen, your Cinco Ranch High School cheerleaders. Tonight, the Cougar Stars are under the direction of drill team director Samantha Cockerham and Christine DC. Let's give a big round of applause for our Cougar Stars also. And now, ladies and gentlemen, if you could please rise for the alma mater of the Morton Ranch High School Mavericks. And now your Cinco Ranch High School alma mater. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight is Cinco Ranch High School Junior Hire Night. The future Cougars from Beck Junior High and Cinco Ranch Junior High are here tonight, so let's give a big round of applause for our future Cougars. Thank you. And here come your Cinco Ranch people!
Live from Rhode Stadium, Katy, Texas. This is Texas 6A High School Football on Texan Live.
Now,
tonight, the Cinco Ranch Cougars
rise and
take on
caps
the Morton Ranch Mavericks.
The national anthem.
We'll
the
have more on the game right after the national anthem.
Corral. The corral is under the direction of Dorothy Wilson.
Good-sized crowd on hand tonight here at Rhode Stadium. Cougars and the Mavericks, two teams going in different directions. Patrick Creighton with you alongside Brent Hallmark. And Brent, the Cougars come into tonight undefeated. They're 4-0, they're 1-0 in district. They come off a 35-7 convincing victory over Maid Creek. The Mavericks, well, they've lost three straight after getting a win to open the season. Last week, they lose a heartbreaker, 50-49, right here against Strake Jesuit. The Cougars trying to keep pace with the Tigers atop the division. The Mavericks trying to find a way to get their season on track.
Well, the Mavericks, that was an embarrassing loss for them last week because twice during that game they had a 21-point lead over Strake Jesuit and then came up on the lower end of a 50-49 score when Strake Jesuit went for two and were able to convert. Cinco, on the other hand, once again, their guys are determined because what their ultimate goal is right off the bat is to dethrone Katy as the 19-6A champions and then set their aspirations to go even further this year in the playoffs than they did in 2014.
So the Mavericks win the toss. They will defer, so they'll kick off. The Cougars will receive. Cougars wearing their home maroons. White numbers, maroon pants, maroon helmets, white trim. Mavericks in the road whites, purple numbers. White pants, purple helmet, white trim. Cougars will kick off. I'm sorry, the Cougars will receive. Mavericks will kick off from left to right as they will defend the north goal. Cougars will receive from the south goal. Joseph Batiste will kick it off for the Mavericks.
Once again, welcome to our future Cougars.
Deep for the Cougars, Brant Keithy.
We were glad to have you coming our way.
And Greg Williams. Back around their own 10-yard line. Batiste lines up his team. Short end over end kick, and we're underway. Fielded at the 13 on the far side, across the 20, 25, bounces into his own man, and he's ripped down at about the 24-yard line. So the Cougars will take over. First drive of the game. First and 10 from their own 23. They're led by quarterback Russell Morrison. The running backs, Devian Johnson, Austin Fraley. The wide receivers, Brandon Green, Sebastian Cifuentes, Greg Williams. Tight end is Corey Rao. Offensive line left to right, Julius Sanders, Ishan Risen, Connor Walsh, Blake Bronstein, and Tyler Worrell. They'll open up two receivers to the right in the gun. Keeper, Morrison, finds a hole across the 30. He's got the first down and more. 40, now across midfield. Down the near sideline, the 40, the 30, the 20, beats another tackle into the end zone for the touchdown, and just like that, the Cougars are on the board.
Wow.
77 yards.
DeAndre Allen made a desperation attempt at a tackle right there around the 10-yard line, but it just wasn't meant to be.
No touchdown. They said he stepped out of bounds. They're moving the ball back. They're going to say he stepped out at the 17. I didn't see him step out at the 17.
I didn't either. I thought he had a clear shot.
But needless to say, it's a 60-yard run on first play from scrimmage. First and 10 from the 17. In the gun. Morrison up the middle. Johnson now bounces to the outside across the 10, very near the first down marker before he's dragged down by a few defenders. Kevin Boudreau went on the tackle.
And assisted by Darius Bryan on that. And saved 6 points on that play.
First and goal from the 6. Morrison in the gun, Johnson. To his left. Givens to Johnson. Bounces to the outside, and he's taken down right about the line of scrimmage. Not a whole lot of room for him there. Sean Williams in on the stop.
On the tackle, number 3, Sean Williams.
So second and goal.
Ball is at the 6.
From the 6. Two receivers left. Ball's on the far hash. Moving right to left. Morrison in the gun. Takes a snap. Up the middle. And
ooh.
Johnson again. Nowhere to go. Got about to the 5, and that was it.
Kevin Boudreau was right there for the stop, right in the middle.
Third and goal.
That'll bring up third down and goal.
Two receivers, short side right. Morrison in the gun, Johnson the deep back. Takes the snap, keeps himself rolling. Now throws to the end zone, incomplete. Looking for his tight end, Corey Rao.
Rao was very well covered by Darian Young. He was right there and broke up that play for the Mavericks.
Now the kicking team will come out. After that exciting first run, where we thought we had a touchdown, you know, this is a win now for the Mavericks to hold this to a field goal. Donnie Smith, 22-yard attempt, kick is up, and it is good. 9:56 to go, first quarter. Cougars are on the board. They grab an early 3-0 lead. You're listening to Texas 6A High School Football on Texan Live.
Come enjoy the heart of Katy, Texas, one of the most delightful cities in the Lone Star State. The best part? It's a short drive from Houston and minutes from the Energy Corridor. With places to stay and places to play, anything you'd like to eat, and an old town charm that can't be beat. Activities and fun for the entire family. Enjoy the best of both worlds in the City of Champions, Katy, Texas. For more information, go to cityofkaty.com.
22-yard field goal from Donnie Smith gets the Cougars on the board. They lead it 3-0, 9:56 to go, opening quarter. Mavericks about to get the ball for the first time. Patrick Creighton, Brent Hallmark with you live from Rhodes Stadium in Katy, Texas.
Patrick, one of the things that I noticed with the Maverick defense in that series is that watching them in previous games, the adjustments that they've made is they're doing more combined tackling schematics than they have in the past. They've relied on one person to try to keep their eye on the ball. Now they're doing more joint tackling, and we'll see if that helps them out through the rest of the game.
Donnie Smith to kick off. Short end over end kick, fielded on a slide by Dartavius Dixon. Right about the 20-yard line is a fair catch, and that's where the Mavericks will get their first possession.
And this is going to be a good test that we're going to see for the Cinco Ranch defense. Dartavius Dixon is the Mavericks' leading rusher. He has combined for about close to 550 yards. He's averaging 9.3 yards a carry so far this season. So it's going to be a good test to see how he can handle up against this Cougar defense.
Nick Hernandez brings the offense to the line. Handoff up the middle. About 2 yards on that play. It's Elijah Dean, the fullback, with the carry. It'll be second down and eight. Ball on the near hash. Nick Hernandez is the quarterback. Dartavius Dixon, Michael White in the backfield. Receiver is Aaron Solomon. The tight end's Jeremiah Green. Eye set. Hernandez under center. Fakes the handoff. Gives himself wrapped up in the backfield. Not a lot of room to go. And I'll tell you what.
Not at all.
That was very fast penetration by the Cougars.
Yeah, Dami Dilasami was the blocker that got him down, forcing the third down conversion. He read that exactly right where he was going and ran in there. And the result, third down.
Third and 10 from the far hash. Hernandez tried to keep it himself, and he's dropped again in the backfield by Ilisami.
Ilisami again was reading the quarterback very well. He knew what Hernandez was doing, came in virtually untouched. Fourth down.
Dami Ilisami back-to-back tackles for loss. And the Mavericks will have to punt. Chris Coleman, the punter. Austin Simmons, deep, high spiral punt, chases Simmons back to the 40, and he'll let it bounce. Takes a Mavericks roll inside the 35 and down at the 31-yard line. So terrific punt and a great bounce. So the Cougars will take over first and 10 from their own 31. 7:55 to go, first quarter. They lead it 3-0. Morrison in the gun, two receivers to the right. Takes a snap, looks right, now fires to the right side over the head of his intended receiver, Brant Keithy, and out of bounds. It'll be second and 10.
Cameron Branch was right there just in case he is able to get that ball.
Two receivers each side. Johnson is a deep back. Morrison in the gun on second and 10. Mavericks show pressure, now throwing left side. It's complete, 35-yard line. Taking a late shot was Corey Rao. He looked to be out of bounds when he took that last shot. It's a 5-yard pickup to the 36. It'll be third and 5.
Tackle by number 20, Darian Young.
Two receivers each side. Johnson is a deep back. Morrison in the gun. Maverick showing blitz. May have jumped. Morrison throws right side, complete for the first down. He's got Jordan Onanaku. Up to the 46, move the sticks, first down Cougars.
And once again, it looked like Darius Bryant was there for the stop.
Three receivers to the left. Morrison takes a snap, looking to throw, rolling right, now firing deep down the middle. It's complete at the 20-yard line to Onanaku, who leapt over three defenders to make that catch. Mark him down at the 18, first and 10 Cougars in the red zone.
Patrick, Cameron Bryant was right there on the coverage, but that was just a perfectly thrown ball.
Two receivers each side. Here comes the blitz. Morris steps up, now fires over the middle off the hands of Rao, and incomplete. I don't think Rao was expecting that ball to come with as much velocity as it did, as Morrison was under pressure and really fired it at him.
Yeah, that front line of the Mavericks was just coming at him, putting all that pressure on there, and I think he probably threw it a little bit sooner than he wanted.
Now Morrison in the gun, takes a snap. He is in trouble, trying to find his way. Gets to a bunch of defenders. I have no idea how he got through that many people across the 10, down to the 8-yard line, and he might have a first down.
It's going to be close. He broke three tackles in order to get it. But Darius Bryant, once again, was there for the tackle, but he did get the first down.
Morrison literally ran through every single defender to get that play. First and goal from the 7. 6.5 minutes to go, opening quarter. Cougars lead 3-0. Two receivers left. Morrison in the gun. Barks a signal. High snap. Takes it. Rolling right. Keeping it himself. He'll get forward to about the 6-yard line.
Russell Morrison on carry. No gain on the play.
Looked like Ryan Lopez was there for the tackle.
Ryan Lopez.
Second and goal from the 6. Ball on the far hash. This is where the Cougars' last drive bogged down. Two receivers to the right. Man in motion, flags fly. That's Corey Rao called for the jump. They'll move the ball back to the 11, second and goal. Cougars have to try not to get bogged down inside the 10-yard line again. Two receivers, short side to the right. Man in motion, will fake the handoff. Morrison under heavy pressure, dumps it off right before he gets hit. Complete, 10-5, diving to the 1.
Davion
Johnson, this time taking the pass, and it's third and one.
Tackle by number 48, Craig Rowe.
Cougars bringing the jumbo package here. Morrison takes a snap. Johnson up the middle, powers it through for the score. But there's laundry on the field. Let's wait for the call. Official now having some conversation with Cougars coach Don Clayton. Now Cougars get called for too many men on the field. They put some big bodies in the backfield. So now it'll be third and six, third and goal from the six.
And that's one of the main penalties. Coaches don't like any penalties, but that is the one penalty that will stick in the craw of every coach, is too many men on the field.
Got to know who's supposed to be on and off the field.
Ball is at the six-yard line.
2 receivers to the right side, short. Morrison in the gun, takes the snap, keeps it himself, right side, dives for the end zone, touchdown Cougars. So it's the third time I've said touchdown Cougars, but this time it counts.
And you got to hand it to Morrison. He broke through about 3 different defenders before he was able to dive into that end zone. 6 points, Cougars.
6-yard touchdown run for Russell Morrison. Donnie Smith on for the extra point. Snap, set, kick is up. And it is good. 4:29 to go, first quarter. Cougars take a 10-0 lead. This is Texas 6A High School Football on Texan Live. Welcome back to Rhodes Stadium. Patrick Creighton, Brent Hallmark with you. 6-yard touchdown run by Russell Morrison. Gives the Cougars a 10-0 lead over the Mavericks. Donnie Smith to kick it off from his own 40.
The Mavericks on that last series did a valiant effort to try to keep that score from happening, but it's going to be interesting to see what adjustments they make to battle both Cinco Ranch's passing and rushing ability.
Dartavius Dixon deep for the Mavericks. Short pop kick up. He fielded at the 26 near the near hash. Now trying to get across the field, across the 30 to the 33-yard line is the return. Looked like DeAndre Allen on the return.
And he had about 4 Cougar defenders bringing him down.
Andrew Fulton on the tackle for the Cougars.
So the Mavericks will get their second possession. First and 10 from their own 34. 4:24 to go opening quarter. Mavericks trailing the Cougars 10-0. Hernandez takes a snap, flags fly. Whistles that earlier, usually against the offense. A false start.
Legal.
Number 45, offense, lined up in the neutral zone.
So Jeremiah Green called for lining up in the neutral zone. So first and 15 now from their own 29. Ball on the far hash, moving left to right. Hernandez under center with the option. Tosses it to Dixon. Dixon is wrapped up for no gain.
Ben Mathisberger was right there on the stop for Cinco Ranch.
No gain on play.
The Mavericks that time running the triple option like Georgia, Tech. Same formation. Hernandez under center. Give his left side. Maybe they got two on the play. Looked like Collier on the carry.
And Austin Simmons was there leading two other Cinco defenders for the tackle.
That'll bring up third down, 13.
Ball is third and 13 now from the 31. Ball on the far hash. Two receivers wide to the right. Eye set. Hernandez under center. Option to Dixon. He gets to the 35, and that's about it. So, 4 yard pickup, but not nearly enough for a first down.
No, Ben Mathis-Meyer and Dami Elusami were there for the stop, forcing the fourth down.
Gain of 4 yards on the play. That'll bring up fourth down and nine for the Mavericks.
So Mathis-Meyer and Simmons.
Chris Coleman.
Deep for the Cougars. Coleman on the punt. Good snap, high spiral, short, fielded at the 36, fair catch called by Simmons. The Cougars will have their third possession, first and 10 from their own 36. 2:23 to go, first quarter. The Houston High School football wrap-up show is tonight. Tune in to Fox Sports Southwest tonight after our game from 11 to midnight. The Houston High School football wrap-up show presented by Texan Drive. Join Howard Chen, John Lopez, Courtney Rowland, and Courtney Madden. They'll take you around the city with all the week's football action. The Houston High School football wrap-up show presented by Texan Drive, 11 to midnight on Fox Sports Southwest. Two receivers each side. Morrison in the gun. Fires to the left. Complete to Rao. And Rao very close to the first down. He's across the 45 at the 46. Let's see where this spot is. We might get a measurement.
Darian Young was right there for the stop. He was assisted by Craig Rhodes.
No measurement needed. First down, Cougars. Two receivers each side. Johnson's the deep back. Morrison in the gun. Here comes the blitz. Morrison fakes the handoff, keeps it himself. Across the 50. Finally brought down the 39-yard line. Morrison with some powerful running. It's Craig Rhodes who made the tackle.
And he may be a little shaken up after that.
So timeout on the field, 2:12 to go. Cougars lead at 10-0. This is Texas 6A High School football on Texan Live.
Hey fans, this is Marvin Driver with Texan Drive Team. Need a car, sedan, truck, van, SUV? Come to the dealership where we treat you better.
I'm Brian Bohannon with the Texan Drive Team. If you want to get your preferred price, make sure you come see us.
This is Tom Huberty at TexanDrive.com. Please come see me for all your vehicle needs.
So Rhodes is okay. He jogs off the field under his own power. First and 10, Cougars from the Maverick 39. Ball on the near hash. Two receivers each side. Morrison in the gun. Barks his signal. Takes a snap. Looks left. Now running right to avoid the pressure. Throwing deep down the right sideline, incomplete. would have been a tremendous one-handed catch.
Yeah, Ryan Holmes was right there on top of him. But what was more impressive was the pressure that Henry Huff was putting on Orison.
Cifuente is just unable to haul that one in. Second and 10. Two receivers each side. Morrison in the gun, barks a signal. Fakes the handoff, keeps it himself. Bounces off a tackler across the 35. Down about the 33-yard line. It's a 7-yard pickup.
Kevin Boudreaux was there for the stop, along with two other Maverick defenders.
Third down and 4 from the 33. Johnson, the deep back, to the right of Morrison. High snap, keeps it himself. Right side across the 30. He's got the first down inside the 25 before he's brought down by a couple of tacklers.
They were led by Henry Huff. And again, it's more of that group tackling that Morton Ranch is using more tonight than they have in previous games. It looks like it's working well for them, but they're still giving up too much yardage.
First and 10 from the 24. 50 seconds to go in the opening quarter. 10-0 Cougars. Morrison under pressure. Rolls right. Fires to the end zone. And it's picked off. Threw that ball off his back foot. Did not have enough on it. Picked off by Ryan Holmes in the end zone. So the Mavericks get their first stop. They'll take over with 42 seconds remaining in the first quarter. First and 10 from their own 20.
Good focus by Holmes. He was one of two defenders that was right there in the end zone in the coverage. Turned around, saw the ball was coming, took advantage of it, grabbed it. Morton Ranch football.
That was just a bad pass by Morrison off his back foot into double coverage. So Hernandez brings his team back out into the triple option, keeps it himself, dives forward to the 24-yard line. It's a 4-yard pickup.
Jacob Smith there for the tackle.
And they do not need to run another play in this quarter. There's a 6-second differential between the play clock and the game clock, but they're coming back to the line. Hernandez under center, fakes the handoff, keeps it himself, fumbles the ball, and it looks like the Cougars have it.
Looked like Jared Williams for the Cougars got that ball, and two plays later, the Cougars have it back.
So after the bad turnover, they get a freebie as Hernandez got caught in between shifting the ball from one hand to the other, got hit, lost the football. 4 seconds remain in the first quarter. Cougars first and 10 from the Maverick 23. Ball's on the far hash. Two receivers to the left. Morrison will fake the handoff. Fires. End zone. Left side. Incomplete. The catch was made by Cifuentes, but he couldn't stay in bounds.
Darian Young was right there forcing him out of bounds before the catch could be completed, ending the first quarter.
After one quarter of play, Cougars 10, Mavericks nothing. This is Texas 6A High School Football on Texan Live.